अस्सलामुअलैकुम, गुड मॉर्निंग। स्टूडेंट्स, आर यू लिसनिंग मी? प्लीज रिप्लाई रिप्लाई इन द चैट बॉक्स प्लीज। ओके, वेरी नाइस ऑफ यू। Students are coming, so I'm waiting for all of you to join me, then I will start my class. Walaikum assalam all of you. There was no homework assignment yesterday. It was just the orientation day, and because of that I have not given you any of the assignment. If you want to ask anything, then I will give you time at the end of my lecture. You can ask anything. Okay, first of all I want to start my today's lecture. I hope you all are doing well. Now I think it's 2 minutes or 3 minutes, so I am giving you today's lecture. This is English language lecture. We are starting from English language because I want to start English literature from the next week when you will join me in the physical class. So I want to start with English language. Okay, I'm Mrs. Afshin Imran, as you know me very well. This is lecture number 1. The topic is tenses. You all know tenses very well. I hope you know all the structures and examples, how to make the sentences of different tenses. It is the repetition of the very important topic, where if you are perfect in tenses, then you will be able to do voices and narrations very easily. So I am going to start. Tense, first of all, I am giving you the definition of tense. The word tense comes from a Latin word. Latin is a language, actually, like English, like Urdu, okay, like French. Latin is another language, and actually the tense is comes from a Latin word, which the Latin word is actually tempus, which means time. Tense is a verb based method used to indicate the time. As you know that when we are using different tenses, we use different forms of verbs there, and because of that it is called verb based method, used to indicate the time and sometimes the continuation or completeness of an action or state in relation to the time of speaking. If you remember that some actions are in continuation, like continuous tenses, or some actions are in completeness, like perfect tenses. So we are doing different kinds of tenses under the heading of tense, but you should know that it is verb based method to indicate the time of an action. Tense of a verb throws light on the time of an action that has taken place, which I have already told you that it tells us about the time of an action. And action, you all know that verb. Verb is an action word. Tense also indicates whether the action is complete, is going on, has been completed in the recent past, or it began at an earlier point and has continued into the present. It means this point tells us about all the four kinds that whether the action is complete, it means present tense or perfect tense, going on, that is continuous tense, has been completed in the recent past, or it is perfect continuous tense, or it began at an earlier point, it shows the past tense. Okay, it means this statement tells us about all the four tenses, that is indefinite tense, perfect tense, continuous tense, and perfect continuous tense. Okay, now I'm moving to kinds of tenses. You all know it very well that we have three kinds of tenses in English grammar. Some of the students are still coming. My voice is clear or not, please tell me, because some of the students are saying that my voice is not clear. Please reply in the chat box. Now I'm telling you that there are three kinds of tenses in English grammar: present tense, past tense, and future tense. You all know them very well. Present tense explains an event that occurs in the present. It means whatever is going now, going on now. Past tense explains an event that occurred in the past. It means the actions that had been completed. Future tense explains an event that will occur in the future, that will be doing or action that will be done in the future. Now I'm going to tell you about present tense. Present tense refers to an action that takes place at the moment of speaking. Like I am speaking at this moment, so all the actions which are doing by me or which are I was telling you, are you listening, students? Again, tell me please, because there is a continuous internet problem. So I hope that you will understand that problem. Now we are discussing present tense. Present tense refers to an action that takes place at the moment of speaking, which I was telling you that whatever I'm doing here, it is present tense. There are some examples. You all know that we are discussing four types of tenses, sub kinds. So I have given you all four examples. The children go to school. You can see that children is plural, so the verb is in first form. The children are going to school. The children have gone to school. The children have been going to school. You can understand from these four examples that there are four subtypes of present tenses. Now we come to past tense. Past tense refers to an action that took place in the past. It means every action that had been taking place in the past, they are referred to as past tenses. And four examples are again here. The children went to school. The children were going to school. The children had gone to school. The children had been going to school. These four examples again tell us that four subkinds of past tenses are there. Now we come to the future tense. Future tense refers to an action that takes place in the future. It means all the actions which will come and done in future, then these are referred to as future tenses. I have given four examples here. The children will go to school. The children will be going to school. The children will have gone to school. and the children will have been going to school. Again, these four examples tell us that there are four sub kinds of future tenses. Now I am going to discuss indefinite tenses today. Okay, you all know that we have four kinds of sub kinds of tenses: indefinite tenses, continuous tenses, perfect tenses, and perfect continuous tenses. Now I am going to discuss indefinite tenses in my today's lecture. Types of indefinite tenses: present indefinite tense, past indefinite tense, and future indefinite tense. You all know it very well that there are three kinds: present indefinite tense, past indefinite tense, and future indefinite tense. So we are going to discuss them one by one. First of all, I am going to discuss present indefinite tense. Present indefinite tense denotes habitual actions and universal truths. Habitual actions which are doing by any person again and again, and universal truths are also included in present indefinite tense. Some students are very much late. Please don't get late because you are missing the important parts of the lecture. So please be there on time. Now I'm going to discuss structures and examples of present indefinite tenses. You all know that when we are doing the tenses, we are doing in three forms: affirmative sentences, negative sentences, and interrogative sentences. So first of all, I'm going to tell you about the structures of affirmative sentences in present indefinite tense. Okay, and you should remember first person, second person, and third person, if you remember the pronouns. So first person pronouns are I and we. Second person pronouns are you, which is also used as a plural form. Then in the third person, you all know that he, she, and they. He, she is the third person singular pronoun, and they is the third person plural pronoun. Okay, you should know that these are the subjective pronouns and you should know them very well, because I have written about under the heading of first person, second person, and third person. If you know them very well, then you can easily understand. Now the structure for first person and second person singular and plural plus third person plural only. Remember, for third person plural, but for first person plural and singular, both. Subject plus verb first form plus object. Remember this structure. First form of verb is always used in present indefinite tenses. For third person singular, we have a little bit change in the structure. Subject plus verb first form plus S or ES. These are added. Okay, when we have third person singular like he or she, then or any other name of a person is given, then we add S or ES in the first form of verb plus object. Now I am showing you some of the examples for the affirmative sentences. I write a letter. You can see that I have written here in the bracket first person singular or first person plural, whatever it is. We write a letter. You write a letter. He writes a letter. She writes a letter. They write a letter. You can see that with he and she, that is third person singular, I have added S with the first form of verb. Otherwise, there is nothing added. Only the first form of verb is used. Okay? I hope you are understanding. These are very easy. Now, I come to the negative sentences and their structures. You know that whenever we make a negative statement, affirmative statement shows the positive meaning. Negative statement shows the negative meaning. It means we must add not in the sentence. But you should remember where is the proper place of adding not. Okay? For first person and second person singular and plural and third person plural, we have the structure subject plus helping verb plus not plus verb first form plus object. Now remember that for the present indefinite tenses, for making the negative sentence, we always add a helping verb. After that, we add not. Okay, and the helping verb is do here. But for third person singular, we have different helping verb: subject plus helping verb plus not plus verb first form plus object. Okay, so the helping verb here is does. Remember which helping verb is used with the subject. You should know them very well. Now I am showing you some of the examples of negative sentences. I do not write a letter. We do not write a letter. You do not write a letter. He does not write a letter. She does not write a letter. They do not write a letter. And you know that in under the bracket, I have shown you that which subject is used or which subjective pronoun is used here. Okay. Now remember that for he and she, the helping verb is does. That is the third person pronoun singular. Otherwise, we use do. Now we come to the interrogative sentences, their structures. Interrogative means whenever we make a sentence by asking a question, it means we use the helping verb in the beginning of the sentence. Remember all those points which I'm telling you and repeating again and again. Okay? For first person and second person singular and plural plus third person plural, we have the structure helping verb plus subject plus verb first form plus object plus question mark. Remember to place a question mark at the end of interrogative sentences. Okay. But for negative and affirmative sentences, you must place a full stop. Now the helping verb is do here. Do must use at the beginning of the sentence. For third person singular, we have the same structure, but the helping verb is different. Helping verb plus subject plus verb first form plus object plus question mark. And the helping verb is does here. Okay. Bisma, I ask. Who is Bisma?
बिस्मा ने कैमरा खोला था, लेकिन वहां पे एक लड़का बैठा था. मैंने कुछ नहीं जवाब बंद कर दिया. कैमरा ऑन तो कर दिया ना, तो क्लास में आपके स्वेट.
Okay, interrogative sentences. I'm showing you examples of interrogative sentences. Do I write a letter? Question mark. Do we write a letter? Question mark. Do you write a letter? Question mark. Does he write a letter? Question mark. Does she write a letter? Yes, Hamza. He is another person. Okay. Do they write a letter? Question mark. I understand that, Hamza. Thanks a lot. You have told me. I hope you all are understanding very well. Now I am showing you past indefinite tenses. Past indefinite tense denotes an action that took place in the past. You all know it very well. Now I'm showing you the structures and examples of past indefinite tenses. First of all, I will tell you again that we are doing past indefinite tenses in affirmative form, negative form, as well as in interrogative form. So first of all, I'm showing you the structure for affirmative sentences. There is only single structure for all the persons in past indefinite tense. For first person, second person and third person, singular and plural. The structure is subject plus verb, second form. Remember, we are using first form of verb in present indefinite tense. And for past indefinite tense, we always use second form of verb plus object. Now, I am showing you some of the examples for affirmative sentences. Remember, affirmative sentences gives a positive meaning. I wrote a letter, we wrote a letter, you wrote a letter, he wrote a letter, she wrote a letter, and they wrote a letter. You should remember that all the persons are used with second form of verb. Now I'm showing you the negative sentences, their structure. For first person, second person, and third person, singular and plural, we have the same structure. Subject plus helping verb plus not plus verb first form plus object. Helping verb is did here. Now I am telling you again that for negative sentences, if you are not having the helping verb in the sentence, original sentence, then we add the helping verb and after that we add not. Okay. So here the helping verb is did. And remember, when we are adding did here, then we change the second form of verb into the first form. Remember all these points which I'm telling you again and again. Now for negative sentences, some examples are here. I did not write a letter. We did not write a letter. You did not write a letter. He did not write a letter. She did not write a letter. They did not write a letter. Now see that I have added did as a helping verb, after that not, and after that I have changed the second form of verb into the first form. Remember this point, that always change the second form into first form when you have added did here. Now I'm showing you the interrogative sentences. Again, only one structure is here for all the persons. For first person, second person, and third person, singular and plural, we have the structure helping verb plus subject plus verb first form plus object plus question mark. Helping verb is did here. Now remember, for interrogative sentences, we must use the helping verb in the beginning and question mark at the end. Again, here you can change the, you have to change the second form of verb into the first form. Now I'm showing you some examples of interrogative sentences. Did I write a letter? Did we write a letter? Did you write a letter? Did he write a letter? Did she write a letter? Did they write a letter? With the question marks at the end. Now remember that whenever I comes, I is a pronoun, which is the only pronoun which has this option, that whenever it comes in between the sentence, we always use it in capital form. Remember that. And you can see that I have added did as a helping verb here. So I have changed the second form of verb into the first form. I hope you have understood till here. Now I move to future indefinite tense. Future indefinite tense denotes an action that will take place in the future. Okay. Everything which will occur in future, it will be in the future tense. I'm showing you the structures and examples for that. Now, again, you know that future indefinite tense can be done in affirmative form, negative form, and interrogative form. Now, I'm showing you the structure of affirmative sentences first. Again, there is only one structure for first person, second person, and third person, singular and plural. We have the same structure, subject plus helping verb plus verb first form plus object, and the helping verb is will here. Remember that for all the persons, we use the same structure. And remember, after the helping verb, we always use the first form of verb in future indefinite tenses. Now, I'm showing you the examples of affirmative sentences. I will write a letter. We will write a letter. You will write a letter. He will write a letter. She will write a letter. And they will write a letter. Again, you can see that I have mentioned which subject is used here. I, we, you, he, she, and they. These are the subjective pronouns. So it has been mentioned here under the bracket that which person is there. Whether it is singular or plural, it is also given here. Now I come to the negative sentences. Their structure first. Again, only one structure is used. for all the persons, for first person, second person and third person, singular and plural, we have the same structure, subject plus helping verb plus not plus verb first form plus object, and the helping verb is will here. Now remember, for negative sentences, we always add not after the helping verb. It means if helping verb is not present in the sentence, we must add it. Okay, if it is already present, we will not add any other thing, any new thing. Okay, if it is already present, we just add not to make the negative one. Now for example, I'm showing you the examples. I will not write a letter. These are the examples for negative sentences. We will not write a letter. You will not write a letter. He will not write a letter. She will not write a letter. They will not write a letter. Here you can see that I have not added any helping verb. The helping verb will is already present in the affirmative sentences. So I have just placed not after the helping verb to make the negative form of these sentences. Okay. There is no other change. I hope you have understood till here. Now I'm showing you the interrogative sentences here, the structure. For all the persons, we are using the same structure for first person, second person, and third person, singular and plural. We have the structure helping verb plus subject plus verb first form plus object plus question mark. Again, remember that for interrogative sentence, we always use helping verb at the beginning of the sentence. And these interrogative sentences must end at the question mark. Okay, and remember to place the full stop for affirmative and negative ones. Otherwise, these sentences remain incomplete. Okay, the punctuation marks are showing the completeness of the sentences actually. If you are not placing the full stop, if you are not placing the question mark, it means the sentence remains incomplete and you are not sure about the completeness of the sentence. Okay, so please remember to place the full stops after the affirmatives and the negative sentences, and for interrogative sentences you must place the question mark. The helping verb is will here. I hope you have understood till here. I'm showing you some of the examples for the interrogative sentences. Again, we start with the helping verb in the beginning. Will I write a letter? Question mark. Will we write a letter? Question mark. Will you write a letter? Question mark. Will we write a, will he write a letter? Question mark. Will she write a letter? Question mark. Will they write a letter? Question mark. Now remember that we have started with the helping verb in the beginning to make the sentence interrogative. And remember again, which I have already told you, that I is the only pronoun which comes or which must be written in the capital form, whether it comes in between the sentence or wherever it is, with the question mark at the end for the interrogative ones. Okay, again you can see that under the bracket I have shown you the subjective pronouns which are used here, first person or second person or whatever it is. I hope you have understood till here. Now I want you to show me your faces. Open your cameras, please. Open your cameras. I want to show your faces. Nabiha, yes. Abdurrahman, very nice. Other people, please show me your cameras. Show me your faces. You are not showing me your own faces, please. Are you sitting here or not? You have opened the cameras, but I can't see your faces. Where are you? Okay, Abdullah, you have told me your reason, but other people, where are you? Okay, show me your faces, please. Some pictures I can't see here. I can't see you. Please show me your faces. Mehta Advani, I think you are throwing. Now, if you want to ask any question, please ask me here. Yeah? I'm waiting. You can ask me questions. Do you have any questions? Whether you were not there, I want to ask. That there is same copy for annual and we have different copy. Yes, Mehta, you have to take different journals for both literature and language. Okay, one for literature and one for language. If you are not understanding anything, you can ask me. There is little bit time left, and I have already told you, but I am repeating once again that yesterday was the orientation class only. And because of that, I have not given you any home assignment. Okay. Now, from now onwards, whenever there is the homework assignment day, I will upload the assignment. Okay. So please don't get worried. There was no assignment yesterday. Are you listening me? Anyone who is not listening me? Are you listening me? Say yes or no. Have you understood everything? Write in the chat box, yes or no. If you have got any question, then you can ask me. Okay, you have understood everything. Very good of you. There is only 2 to 3 minutes left. If you have got any question, I have told you about the books yesterday that you have got. You have to purchase English literature book syntax book board. Okay, you can ask from any bookshop. Very good, Falia. You have given me the reply. Anas, yes, I can see you. Anas Siddiqui. Bilal, I can't see you. Your face is not okay. Nice, very nice. Zimal, both language and literature journals are separate. Okay, there will be no portion in any of the journal. Remember this. You have to purchase two journals, one for literature and one for language. Okay, and from Monday there will be regular classes. So you should purchase the journals before that. Meta Advani, please go to the book stalls again on Saturday. I think then after 2 or 3 days, books will be available. Okay? Otherwise, in the next week, they will be available. Purchase the books as soon as possible and journals as well, because we will do the written work from Monday. Zima, leave one page for any title. Okay, don't make any title. I will tell you on Monday when you will join the class. Okay, Meta, it's okay. If you have journals, you have to wait for the books. Books will be available within 2 or 3 days in the market. Yes, Nabia. Just wait. Don't get worried. Only 4 or 5 days will be there. After that, you can purchase the books. Literature book is common. There is disturbance or no problem when you will go to the shop and ask about the syntax book board book, 9th class. Okay? It will easily be available. And some of you are very much late in my today's class. And one thing more, that you are leaving and joining what is going on. Please, don't do that again and again. I will not allow you to join my class after 5 minutes after the beginning of the lecture. So please be careful from next time.